I'm Dr. Rosemary Cuglieri, high school principal, and I would like to welcome you to our spring choral concert. As usual, there is a wonderful presentation of talent in store for us tonight. Additionally, the spring choral concert is always a special event because it marks the last choral concert for our seniors. So I would like to take a minute and to recognize the music students of the class of 2017. It has been very exciting to see them mature in their music and also academically for the past 4 years or so. And they are truly a wonderful group of young adults, and we're going to miss them very, very much. So later on, there'll be more tribute to our seniors as well. I would also like to thank all of our music students for their hard work and dedication to our music program, and our parents and guardians and music boosters that support them. A special thank you to our choral director, Mrs. Abby Kirkpatrick, for arranging our program tonight and for the teamwork of our entire music department. So without further delay, let's begin our program, and I'd like us to welcome Mrs. Kirkpatrick, and our course is already set up and ready to go. Thank you.
Thank you.
We're very excited for that. You also notice that each verse of the song is going to be started by a different soloist. We're going to start with Blake Amato, then you'll hear from Martin Zabatsky, Emily Getman, Anthony Wood, April Raver, Julia Sowers, and Jenna Stanton. So this is Mputsula. The translation is in your program.
Streets make me cry. Yeah. Wash my hands of that for this? Miss my mom and dad for this? No. When I see stars, when I see stars, that's all they are. When I hear songs, they sound like this one, so come
Thank you. a very modern piece written by a composer who's still living, Eric Whitaker. Eric Whitaker uses all the notes that are right next to each other to create these dissonances and chords that you're not going to hear in our other choir music tonight. So real quick, I'm going to list your voice part, and I want you to raise your hand when I name it. Soprano 1, soprano 2, soprano 3, soprano 4, soprano 5, alto 1, alto 2, alto 3, alto 4, tenor 1, tenor 2, tenor 3, bass 1, bass 2, bass 3. That doesn't happen usually. There are a few times in this piece where all of those parts are saying a different note, and you will hear them. That's what it's supposed to sound like. I just wanted to clarify. Now, because of that, you get these beautiful textures that you don't get in other music, and it's just really beautiful. We hope you enjoy Water Night.
Thank you.
we'll be doing for you today is Ride a Rose, and what I'd like to tell you right from the Music Man. And I'm going to also take this one off stage, so I hope you enjoy expression lessons.
Thank you. concert choir, which, in contrast to chorus, is mostly upperclassmen. And that's why we have to say goodbye to our seniors out of this group in a little bit. But we're going to celebrate some good music with them first. The first song you've heard is My God Is So High, and we featured Junior Seth Shields on that solo. And next we're going to be hearing Esto Les Digo, which is in Spanish. You're going to be hearing soloist Hunter Eschbach at the end. The translation is also in your program. Hope you enjoy.
Save all.
of our students auditioned for and made, so that was a hard piece. And yes, it was in German. I had to learn all of that German. We worked together, Emily Gittman, with our resident German expert over here. She loved that class. Our next piece, also from a PNH region chorus festival, Witness, is a lot of fun. We hope you enjoy.
And her favorite piece was The Awakening.
She'll be attending Shippensburg University and majoring in Spanish, so esto les digo is right up your alley then. We wish you the best, Lauren. Thank you. Maddie Duffner. Maddie was in chorus for 2 years and concert choir for 2 years. She's also a member of the band and the orchestra, so I got to say goodbye to her last week as well. She's also a member of Tryon, and she just brings a smile to the music department, probably quicker than almost anybody I know. So Maddie's going to go to Messiah and study physical therapy, so we wish you the best of luck, Maddie, this year. Lindsay Berger. Lindsay was in chorus for 2 years and concert choir for 2 years and is also a part of Expressions. She did the musical this year for her first time as her senior year. Her favorite piece was True Light. And she's going to be studying occupational therapy at Central Penn. She's also going to be one of our soloists in our last piece this evening. We wish you best of luck, Lindsay. Taylor Goldheimer. Taylor was in concert choir for 2 years and chorus for over 6 years if you include middle school, so she is definitely dedicated to singing. Favorite piece was also The Awakening, and she plans to be involved in community music somehow next year, so we'll have to be talking about how we can get you plugged in, Taylor. We wish you the best of luck next year. Next year is Sarah Dessman. Sarah was in chorus for 2 years, and this is her first year in concert choir. Her favorite piece is Lean On Me, which you haven't even heard yet, so hopefully they don't disappoint, right, Sarah? That's your favorite one, yeah. She's going to be studying beauty at Empire Beauty School next year, so we wish you the best of luck, Sarah. Next we have Katie Gallagher. Katie was in chorus for 4 years and concert choir for 4 years. And she's also a member of Expressions. Katie's made a lot of our district festivals all the way through Allstate and to all nationals last year, so definitely want to congratulate her on those achievements through her high school year. She's also a member of Tryon, and she's going to be attending Liberty University to major in music and worship next year. Best of luck, Katie. Next is Zach Carmen. And now you know Zach a little bit more. Zach's been in concert choir for 2 years, also a very active member of the band in the low brass section. He does an awesome job. He's in Expressions this year, and he was our Tryon president, actually, this year. He's going to be going to Penn State as a civil engineering major, so we wish you the best of luck, Zach. We have Eli Hoff, who was in concert choir this year, right, only year? Awesome, we're glad to have you. Eli also did the musical this year, and I will tell you, he brings the smiles to the stage. You do not have to tell Eli to give you facial expression, it just comes out naturally. He's a very joyful presence on stage, and we love that. We wish you the best of luck, Eli, next year. Next we have Don Mascaro. Each other. It's great. 2 years in concert choir, one of our basses, and is also a trombone player in band, jazz band, and also worked with me at the Pitt Orchestra this year for the musical, and was our Tryon vice president. So we love having Don over in the choir role for the last 2 years, and we just wish you the best of luck next year, Don. Hannah spent 2 years in chorus and 2 years in concert choir, and her favorite piece was One Day More from Les Mis. Very dramatic piece, we love it. And is going to be attending HAC next year. We wish you the best of luck, Hannah. Next we have Kayla Payton. She was in chorus for 4 years, concert choir for 3. Her favorite piece was Wanting Memories, and she's going to be majoring in business at IUP. Now, let me tell you one more thing about Kayla. Is that she is in the room and she is laughing, so are you. She's a very infectious laughter, so Kayla, I just want you to take that laughter wherever you go next year, okay? We wish you the best of luck. Next we have April Raver. April was in chorus for 3 years, concert choir for two, and this year was also in expressions, and when I asked what their favorite pieces were, I wanted to be very specific about this answer. All capital letters, water night, 3 exclamation marks. I wanted to make sure that was gotten across. April plans to stay involved in music in the community, and I absolutely believe that April's a big lover of music. April, we wish you the best of luck next year. I know Kylie's always running around interviewing people. We see her on the morning announcements, and she did a little bit with the fall plays here. Kylie, we wish you the best of luck as you study journalism. Nicole Seymour. Nicole is in chorus for 4 years, concert choir for two, and her favorite pieces were like all of the African American spiritual stuff we did, so like Witness and My God Is So High. We try to do some of those every year, so I love those too, so we share that in common. Nicole, we wish you the best of luck next year. Next we have Taylor Shive, one of our altos. Taylor Shive's been in chorus ever since middle school and concert choir this year. We're so glad you joined for your senior year. And she just couldn't pick one favorite. So I know a lot of us would probably like that. I know I'd be like that. Taylor, we're so glad to have you in concert choir and chorus this year, and we just wish you the best of luck next year. You know him as Ali Hakam. You probably made you laugh right on this stage. That was probably my best memory of you, being Ali Hakam. His favorite piece is Omani Mysterium that we sang last year, and he will be joining the Army after graduation. We just wish you the best of luck with that. Best of luck, Andy. She's also very active with the color guard, both in the marching band season and in the indoor color guard season over the winter. Her favorite piece was 900 Miles, and her plans for next year are to attend Millersville. We wish you the best of luck. Seniors, I want to just thank you as a whole for your leadership over the last 2 years as I've known you. We've never had any issues with you. You're always just calm, relaxed, and a lot of fun, so I just really thank you for that. My advice to you, of course, has to be tied to our last song, of course. So I just want you to be thinking about not all of the lasts that you're going to be experiencing in the next couple weeks, but I want you to be thinking of all the firsts that are about to come. You may have your first full-time job, maybe your first bills you have to pay, maybe your first college essay due that you're up at 2 a.m. Maybe you'll have the first class that you love, maybe you'll have a first class that you don't love. Maybe you'll have a first apartment, a first roommate, things that you might not have had to deal with yet. These firsts might become overwhelming, and believe you, some days they will be. But you're not alone. You're not the only ones experiencing them. Look around, the people are around you. They are going to be experiencing them too. And look out to the audience. They went through it. They are here to support you tonight because they love you, and they are here to support you through your next year as you are figuring out life. There will be ups and downs, I promise. Focus on the ups. The downs will go away. When you're feeling down, call your friend. Don't just text them. Call them, Skype them, see them. When you're on break, hang out, get coffee, get pizza. Talk through those stressors. I'm sure you'll realize that we're all just going through this together. Call your mom and dad. I still call my mom almost every week. It's okay. They want to hear from you. Call your siblings. Make them your friends. There are so many people that are around you that want to support you through your firsts. Lean on them. There's going to be time when they need to lean on you, so be there for them. We are all here for you. We want to see you succeed. We want to help you succeed. I'm so proud of all of you, everything you've done over the last few years, and everything I know you're going to do. I want to keep hearing about it, so keep coming back, keep visiting. I'm sure with whatever you choose to do with your life next year that you're going to just do a great job, because I know you individually, and I know that you worked hard in concert choir and chorus, so I know that you're going to work hard next year. Ladies and gentlemen, the choir students of the class of 2017.
I would just like to have everyone give a round of applause to Mrs. Kirkpatrick for all of her. But also in a personal, and she's always making sure that we're okay as a person, not only a student, and I'd really like to thank her for that. And not only did she do the orchestra this year for musical, but she also took on choral and the orchestra this year, so that was awesome. She was able to work even more and more with us, and just watching her grow as a teacher is just amazing because she's so awesome, and I'm so excited to see how well she does coming back to the concerts for next year. And in this time, we have a picture. Does anybody can run back and get it? All right, so we have a picture frame. Actually, ironically, Mrs. Kirkpatrick this year, we do teacher superlatives here, not only senior superlatives, we do teacher superlatives, and Mrs. Kirkpatrick got most likely to be mistaken for a student. Had some seniors sign around the matting, so you're able to hang it up and just remember this awesome superlative, and also some seniors that we have here. So that's our gift to you. And also we have April Raver, a student who has a special message for you, and we got this pot here that says, "Thank you for helping us grow," with flowers in it. And we are just so grateful for everything that you've done for us and these 2 years that you've been with us when you came along. So just in those 2 years, you've done so much to help our music program and just us as a person. So we have April here who's going to tell you a little bit about our next gift, our last and final gift here.
Okay, so I'm not good with words in the first place. And in the second place, there are not words that can describe what Miss K means to me. I never thought I'd care so much for a teacher. But, so, instead of using words, when words fails, we use music. So this is a setting of the poem, Go Lovely Rose, composed by me and performed by some of the members of the senior class, especially for today, for Miss K.
We hope you enjoy, and after we are finished, we hope you have a great night, and we'll see you next year.